Yes, welcome to second part of the lecture for chapter number 19, magnetism. We did discuss half of the chapter. Please thank you first of all watching for the channel. Subscribe it, like it if you like it. Turn on the notification so that you get a quick notification whenever I upload the new videos, and share it with your friends. They might get benefit from these lectures. And we already discussed the force on a charged particle when it is moving in a magnetic field. And now, next topic is magnetic force F on a conductor of length L in magnetic field B carrying a current I. So you have a conductor whose length is L. I mean, L is the length of the conductor which will be in the magnetic field, keep in mind. And you see, whenever you have a conductor and when you connect it with the supply, with the voltage, the battery, what is the job of the battery or the supply? It moves the charges within the circuit. So we call it electric current. So initially we did the force on a single charge. Now once you have conductor of length L, you have many charges moving through the conductor. And we have electric current due to that. So electric current, conventional current we use from positive to negative terminal of the battery, it will be like this one, this direction, and it will experience some force. We are going to discuss all those things. So first of all, you remember when you did the force on a charge Q moving with velocity V in the magnetic field B, like this one, right? And the magnitude was equal to like this one, and direction, of course, right hand rule number one we used. Now, whenever you have conductor of length L, current I is flowing through it in the magnetic field. So this is the force, magnetic force, F sub B or F sub M, or simply F, the same thing. By the way, it is the magnetic force. Again, as we discussed in the first topic, that the force on a charge in the magnetic field, moving charge in the magnetic field, one magnetic field you have already set by permanent magnet or the electromagnet, for example, and the moving charge has magnetic field around it. So due to two magnetic fields, interaction of those two fields, interesting result we already discussed in that case, that charge experiences a magnetic force. Similarly, when you have a conductor of length L, current I is flowing through that, due to current we always have a magnetic field around that conductor, and one magnetic field around the conductor due to the current, and the second magnetic field we have already set it, so this is cross into. Okay, magnetic field direction, this is into, cross into. Now, in place of Q, we have I, right? In place of V, we have L. Keep in mind, don't think that you can write current here. That is the myth, that is the misunderstanding. Many of the students, they think that it should be current I here. No way. If you need some proof and verification, please write in the comments. I will guide you, because it will be complete lecture. Complete lecture to explain that current. Of course, current has a direction, right? But a direction magnitude. But all magnitude, the physical quantities, if they have magnitude and the direction, it doesn't mean that they are vector. And because the reason here is that current does not obey the law of vector addition,
right? Okay, so I will discuss about it later on, but keep in mind that we take length vector, you see, length vector.
All right, because current does not obey the law of vector addition.
Okay,
now this is the rule for that. And you know, what we do, we have an experimental arrangement. You have a conductor here, you connect it with the battery and current flows through it, and we have a magnetic field around that conductor. This is magnetic field due to the permanent magnet. So one magnetic field due to permanent magnet, second magnetic field around this conductor due to the current flow. So two magnetic fields interact, and we have interesting result that this conductor will experience a force. Now, the direction of that force, you know, we use again right hand rule number one for this one also. And if this is the current direction or the length vector, and this is B from L, which is current direction from length vector to magnetic field D, thumb will give you the direction of the force on that. Okay, similarly, I mean, if for example I have like this one, okay, if you have like this one, I think about three-dimensional coordinate system. Okay, if this is current direction and the length vector, okay, which is current direction, and this is magnetic field B direction. So from current direction, which is the length vector, to magnetic field B, Z axis, you know, top upward will be the force of magnetic force on this conductor. This is how we use this rule. And by the way, let me write the magnitude ILB sine theta. Direction, right hand rule number one, and the magnitude like this one. I is the current, B is the magnetic field, F is the force, and L is the length of the vector, which is in the magnetic field. Keep in mind, this is into, and dot we use out of. Now, magnetic force on a current, we are doing. Now, for example, you have this piece of wire, current. Right now, you don't have any current. When there is no current, but you have magnetic field, which is into, right? Magnetic field into. Current is zero. You see, the wire remains vertical. There is no force. Okay, no current. Okay, current is zero, so force is zero because you have this rule. F is equal to ILB sine theta. Once you have current zero, so force will be zero. That's the first case. You get the point? Because whenever you have current, then you will be having magnetic field around it, and two magnetic fields will give rise to the force on this conductor, by the way. Now, look at this. When the current is upward, okay, current is upward, magnetic field into, you see, right hand rule number one, current up, magnetic field B into 90 degree angle from current direction, which is length vector. In fact, magnetic field B, what is the direction of the force? To the left. You get the point again. Right hand rule number one. Like this one. From the current direction to magnetic field. Thumb will give you the direction of the force. If you have like this one, this force. Like this one, this force. Now, right now we have current up, magnetic field into. Okay? Like this one. From the current direction to current direction up, magnetic field into. From current to magnetic field left. So this is done. These are the example I'm explaining. I mean, how we can use the right hand rule number one for whenever you have current and whenever you have magnetic field. So two magnetic field will interact, and there will be force and direction we are interested most of the time, because it's really very crucial for you to decide the direction. Now, current is now down, right? Okay, current is down, magnetic field into. Current direction to magnetic field. Turn to the right. I hope you get the idea now. Let's do this example. Please don't hesitate to put the comments. And if you have any questions, do write down questions. I will explain it for you. Don't worry. This is the purpose of these lectures, in fact. So you have only a part with you. A wire carries a current of, this is the current I, from west to east. Because these are the directions, east, west, north, south. East, west, east, west, north, south, up, and down, six directions. Don't think just four. All right. So big, because this is the board, so don't be confused that this is north is up. North is horizontal this side, and south is opposite. And we have up and down also. Assume magnetic field is horizontal and directed from south to north. So B is B is north, okay? Not up, it is north. As I told you, that like this one. This is east, this is west. This is north, and this is south, horizontal. And this is up, and this is down. Up and down, six directions. So right now you are given, you know, east you have length vector or the current direction here, okay, east, and this one, and the north you have what? Magnetic field. So this you have current direction, length vector, and this one here, so angle is 90 degrees, okay? All right. Okay, this is B. This is minus 4, right? Okay, this is minus 4. Minus 4, Tesla. Okay, find the magnitude and direction of the magnetic force. This is L. Magnetic force. I'm using the vector form because you have to find out the magnitude and the direction both. So first of all, direction. As I told you that this is your current direction, which is the length vector, of course, and the north is B. So from the current direction, which is the length vector, in fact, to magnetic field B, so thumb indicates direction will be up. So the direction of the force will be up. Okay,
So
force direction. Not north, okay? Because this is given, this is east. Okay? Which is the L unit vector, in fact. Right. Now, the magnitude, you have F is equal to ILB sine theta. Right? Current length, how much? 36B, 0.500 times 10 to the minus 4, theta is 90 degrees. So you get the magnetic force on this conductor 3.96 times 10 raised to power minus 2 Newton. Now, another important topic now, which is the magnitude of the magnetic field of a long straight wire. And right. You see, if you have a long straight wire, of course, current is flowing through it. This rule, which we call the Ampere's rule, in fact, it is used to find out the magnetic field B, right? And we use for this right hand rule number 2 for direction. In fact, first let's discuss about B is equal to this much, mu naught I is the current flowing through the, you know, for example, in this conductor, long conductor, R is the radius, and magnetic field lines are circular around, you know, any state conductor. Magnet, these four fingers give you, you know, the magnetic field directions. Okay, so mu naught is a constant. We call it permeability of free space. Its value is 4 pi times 10 to the minus 7 tesla meter per ampere. This is the actually 2 pi r is the circumference of circle where you have the magnetic field lines. Okay, in fact, you see, you are going to find out the magnetic field. How much is the magnetic field around this? Because we have discussed this concept that whenever you have a current flowing through some conductor, you have magnetic field around that conductor. So what is the direction of the magnetic field B, and what is the magnitude? Actually, it depends upon magnetic field is directly proportional to the current in the conductor. If you have large value for the current, you will be having stronger magnetic field around that. Okay, and similarly, this is directly proportional to, you know, the circumference, 2 pi r, or you can say 1 by r, inversely proportional. If r is smaller, field will be stronger. So by combining these two, we can write b is directly proportional to I over 2 pi r. If I remove this symbol of proportionality, I must write equal with some constant, which is mu naught or mu zero, permeability of free space. This is a constant to be given to you, by the way. Right? So we get this result. The magnitude of the magnetic field B around a straight conductor. Alright. What is the rule number 2, as I discussed that for direction we use right hand rule number 2, not 1. Okay? Right. What is the rule? You can hold this conductor in right hand rule in your right hand, keeping the direct thumb in the direction of the current. Okay? Don't hold it, because sometimes you have naked wires or you know, electric short circuit risk, electric risk. And the rule is, just think, don't hold this conductor. Sometimes heavy currents are flowing. Okay, like this one, you see, this is the current up now. Current is up direction, right hand rule. Thumb in the direction, keep your thumb in the direction of the current, magnetic field lines, you know, like this. If the current is down, put your thumb down, and the direction of the magnetic field lines will be opposite. Keep in mind, the magnetic field lines are circular, and their direction depends upon the direction of the current. Right hand rule number 2 we use, okay? Right. That's all. Thank you very much and have a nice day. Good luck.